Hi guys, welcome to AbSense Pro, welcome to another video. In this video, I'm gonna show you guys how you can add stylish looking widget on your product page. That widget will not be using with any app. You don't need any app to add the widget. You can create your own bundles with this widget, which is gonna look awesome on your product page. So that's the tutorial, and that's how your product will look like. So you can see the quantity selector is like bundled. So if you buy one piece, you're gonna have 0% discount, but if you buy three pieces, you're gonna get 10% discount, and you can display stylish boxes like this similarly for five pieces, right? And if I add this on my cart, click on add to cart, you can see that we have this 20% discount added on that product. So I'm gonna show you how you can set this up on your own product page. And as you can see, I have multiple other custom functionalities added, like the slider, the product slider. And if I click on add to cart, you can see it's adding this confetti effect, which you can also add on your product page. But this tutorial is just for this widget, which we're gonna add. All other tutorials I have created on my YouTube channel, more than 150, maybe 200 videos for adding these different UI sections and blocks on your stores. If you are new to this channel, I have created like 200 plus tutorials on how you can add these stylish looking like this testimonial, like this bar, which we are seeing when we scroll down. We have this sticky add to cart bar, and we have this confetti effect. We are just seeing this payment icons, which are not in the built-in functionality. And if I go to the homepage, you can see we have transparent header. And if I hover over or click on the menu, we have images on menu, which is mega menu. We have this cool looking video, which is continuously working on autoplay. We have this collection slider and lots of other sections which I have created, and all of these sections are available completely for free. You don't have to pay a single penny. You don't have to sign up for any newsletter or anything like that. All of the tutorials created completely for free. All you have to do is just subscribe this channel and turn on the notification if you want to be aware of the latest tutorials which I create. So yeah, this before after slider also looks good, right? So let's proceed with the current tutorial. And for current tutorial, we will be adding this widget on our product. And I'm also gonna show you the app which we have created for adding the volume discount. It is the cheapest app available for adding volume discount. So this is the widget which you'll be getting completely for free. But to add volume discount, we need a dynamic functionality. For that, you will need an app. And the app which you will be needing is called Big Bulk Discount. This is the app which we created to add volume discount on your product page. And the app is just $1.99 a month, which is, if you count it on your day basis, it's like less than 6 cents. So if you are spending about 6 cents daily for getting more sales, and if it gets you like 5% increase on your sale on daily basis, or if it gives you on monthly basis 5 to 10% increase, then this app is way more cheaper, because volume discount is a really cool way to boost your sales. It helps increase the average order value, because obviously you are incentivizing your customer to add more products to the cart. So make sure to try our app and watch this video completely, where I'm going to show you this widget which we'll be adding via code. And then we will be using this app to create a volume discount. In future, this widget will be the built-in functionality of our BVD. So you won't have to play with the code. All you will need is just install the app, and this widget will automatically show up whenever you create a discount for the product. But it's gonna take us some time, but we will definitely have this functionality on this app. Okay, so without further ado, let's hop onto this tutorial, and that's the link which you will need to follow. Link will be in the description. All of the code instructions will be in the description. So let's proceed by first navigating to the backend of the online store. Okay, now I am going to click on online store. I am going to install a fresh DOM theme. The reason why that is because I have added a lot of customization in this theme, and I want you to show you guys that it's gonna work completely fine on all of the theme. It's not just the free theme, it's gonna work completely on all of the themes. But we use DAWN for the testing purposes, so let's install that. Click on add. Okay guys, it's being installed. And guys, while it's being installed, if you are new to Shopify and you want your store for just $1 a month, link in the description, use this link to sign up for your Shopify store. for just $1 a month, limited time offer. So make sure to sign up quickly and save like around $90, because in 3 months you'll be sending around that. So you can have this feature for just $1 a month. Our Dawn theme has been installed. Okay, now I'm going to publish this theme. Perfect. And now let's preview our theme. And I'm going to close this older window here. And here we go. So this is our theme, and I am going to set up the widget for this product, leather case for AirPods. We will be displaying widget on this product, right? So let's start doing that. Click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Before editing the code, I suggest you guys to have a duplicate of your theme. In case you mess up anything, please don't blame me that I messed up your code. I always suggest whenever I'm doing changes, something like that, to have a duplicate of your theme. Okay, let's click on edit code. And first thing we're gonna do is search for main-product.liquid file. So that's our main-product.liquid file. And within this file, we will be searching for quantity selector. And here we go. So that's our normal default quantity selector. And above that code, we will be adding this code here. As mentioned here in the main product.liquid file, search for this code and paste this code above this one. So I'm just going to click on copy code here and then paste our code above it. Once you do that, search for quantity selector again, and you will be taken here. So we will be adding one more code after these three lines, and make sure to notice this comma, because that's really important. If you remove that or you add double commas, it's the code's gonna give you the error that is not properly formatted. Okay, after this comma, I'm gonna add the line break, which is also mentioned in our tutorial. So if you scroll down, you can see that it's asking to search for this code, right? And once you search for this code, add the following code. So click on copy code and then paste the code. Perfect. After pasting the code, click on save. And then we will be creating a new snippet. So from this arrow here, click on add new snippet. And we will name our file just like mentioned in our step two. So that's our step two, where we are creating a new snippet file. So I'm just going to copy the name from here, which is bulk quantity dash picker, and then paste the name here, so bulk dash quantity dash picker, and then click on done. Once you do that, we have all of this code which you need to paste. So click on copy code and then paste this code. Perfect. Click on save. And now we should have our widget showing up. So if I click on customize theme and go to my product page template, okay, our customizer is open. Now I am going to navigate to my product page. And here's our product page. Let's go to our product, which is leather case for AirPods. That's the product where we need to add the widget, right? And here, if I scroll down and then click on this add block here, so we have this add block showing up here, right? Click on this plus sign to add the block. Here, I am going to search for this bulk quantity picker. That's the custom block which we have created when we added this schema code in our main-product.liquid file. That's what we created, right? Now click on bulk quantity picker, and you can see that it's now showing our pricing. It's automatically detecting the product price. You don't have to add in the price manually. You can see for one piece, it says $39.99. For three piece, it's saying $35.99 per piece from $39.99. Similarly, for five piece, we have $31.99. Now, you can customize all of the colors. So if I click on that, you have the option to customize the colors. Here we have all of the color settings, right? So if I change the active background to red, you can see it's showing up as red. And this is the badge background color. So let's change it to maybe black. Yep. And similarly, all of the colors can be changed here. Discount, text size, we can increase the text size here. You can see we have increases this discount text size here. You can reduce it back to 1.1, which looks more good. Okay, here we have the unit, which is piece. So let me go over all of the settings from the top. So currently it's set to show on all products. I am going to deactivate that. And now I'm going to select only this product. So it's going to display only on this product. Click on select product. And then we will select this product. And now it's going to show only on this product. Sorry, I selected the wrong product. So I am going to replace it with leather case for AirPods. Okay, that's the product, right? So it's showing up on this product. You can also choose a whole complete collection. So if you don't want to display it only on one single product, you can display it on one specific collection as well, right? And here is the label. So if you want to set one piece to one item or maybe something else, you can just name the bundle item to whatever you want. And here we have the quantity. So this is the quantity which is going to be added to the cart. So if someone select this bundle and click on add to cart, it's going to add this one piece of this product, right? Similarly, we have here the discount. So you have to mention what is the discount which you are giving on this. So if one piece, we are not giving any discount. It's the default pricing when someone select one piece. And that's the badge. So you can show multiple badges as well. Here we have high in demand. But we don't want to display it on here because we are not offering any discount. So I'm going to deactivate that. Here we have three piece bundle. And you need to mention the quantity which is going to be used for adding to the cart. So three items to the cart will be added when someone click on this. Right? And here's the discount. So mention the number of discount here. So this discount is just for the displaying purposes. Actual discount, which we will set up, is on the app, which I'm going to show you guys. So it's just for the preview purpose. When so if I click on save and go to this product and select this three piece bundle. And one more thing, you will have to hide this default quantity selector. So I'm going to hide this default quantity selector, hide that from this eye icon here. So you can click on this icon to hide that, right? Okay, now let's click on save. And if I now hit refresh, we don't have the default quantity selector, we have these bundles selector. And if I select, for example, five piece, it's going to add the five item to the cart. You can see it added five item to the cart. But if I go to the cart, it's not going to show the discount. You can see we don't have discount showing up. And the discount part is being set up in the app, which I'm going to show you. So let's first go through all of the settings in the widget. Perfect. Let's click on our bulk quantity picker, right? And I am going to set it for all products for now. And yep, so these are the settings. Similarly, we have here the quantity, the discount, the show badge, and the badge text, right? And here is the title. If you want to change the choose quantity to be quantity, so this is for this here. So if you notice this quantity, we are changing it here. So this quantity title is coming from here, right? And this piece label is coming from here. So this piece you're seeing here is from this, right? So, here we have the option to show original price. We can also deactivate that. Show back price if you want. You can see all of the changes showing up here. So you can customize this widget a lot. And again, you have all of these options. Here we have the corner radius option. So let's increase it to 1.2. That looks a little better. Perfect. Here we have different sizing, pack bottom spacing, title size, all of that kind of stuff, right? So let's click on save. And now I'm going to set up the discount part for this product. So we are offering 0% if someone buys one item, but if someone buys three items, it's going to give 10%. And if someone buys five items, it's going to give 20%. Now, let me show you how easy it is to set up in our app. So let's go to our app. So first you will have to do is just go to this app, the link in the description, and click on install. Currently I'm seeing open because I've already installed that app on my development store. And this is completely free for development store. If you're a developer and you're testing that out, you won't need to pay anything. You can use this app on your development store for as long as you want. So here's the first page, pretty simple. Just click on create discount button here and you will have the option to create discount. Okay, here's the discount option, and I'm gonna name my discount as leather case discount. And we are offering for three items 10%, and for five items we are offering 20% discount. And here we have the option to select the collection or product. I'm currently setting this up for the product, so I'm going to select specific product, select that product. And this is the product which we want to select. Click on add. And here we have the product showing up. You can add more products as well if you want, but I want this for just product, only for this product, right? So let's click on save. And our discount is created successfully. Now, if I go to discounts, you can see my discount showing up here. And the type of discount, you can click on that and edit if you want. So if you go to edit screen, you can change the percentage and quantity, right? Now, if I hit refresh on this product, and now if I add three items to the cart, click on add to cart, click on view cart, you can see that it's applying the 10% discount, right? And if I try to, let's first delete these three items and now add five items to the cart. Click on add to cart. Go to the cart. And now you can see that we have 20% discount showing up here. So that's it for the video, guys. I hope you guys like it. You would add this widget and show this cool looking widget on your store. And again, this is going to be a built-in functionality in our app in near future. So we are really close to adding this in our app, and we'll be adding this within a month or two. So you don't have to follow this code thing. It will be automatically added on your product page. And that's it for the video, guys. If you have any questions related to app or related to this widget, let me know in the comments below. I try to answer all of the comments, and I'll keep doing that until I don't know how long. Okay, that's it for the video, guys. Until next video, have a great day.